Hello you guys, welcome to Designer How, back with another tutorial for you. Today we're going to turn some regular footage into a surreal, dreamlike sequence. Let's get right into it. On the timeline we have our footage, and the first thing we'll want to do is head into Effects, type RGB, and drag the color balance effect onto our clip. We'll make two copies by holding Alt and dragging them above our original. For the first clip, in Effect Controls, set blue to 100 and put red and green at 0. For the second clip, put green at 100 and the other two at 0. For the last clip, set red to 100 and bring everything else down to 0. We now have three layers, each with one of the RGB colors, perfect for the dreamy RGB split we want to achieve. For the upper two layers, set blend mode to linear dodge add. Then for the upper layer, set scale to 104, do the same for the middle layer, but set this one to 102. For the lower layer, we won't change anything. We'll leave scale at 100. Already, the RGB split effect is visible on our footage. We'll head into the project panel, click the icon for new item, and click adjustment layer. Drag the adjustment layer up on top of the clips and match them in length. Back in effects, type Gaussian and drag the Gaussian blur effect onto the adjustment layer. Create an ellipse mask by hitting the oval icon under Gaussian Blur. Set the value for blurriness anywhere in the 30s and drive up the mask expansion to create a vignette. Hit the box for inverted. The blur now reaches everywhere except for the center. This will create an emphasis on the focal point for our project. Drive up the mask feather to soften the edges to our blur effect. Tweak the settings to what you think best fits your footage. Every scene is different, so it is possible your project looks better with slightly different settings. Just go with your gut, or just copy the settings you see here, I don't care. Now to finish up, we will add a light zoom out effect and some more distortion. Select the three clips of footage, right click, and select nest. Select your nested clip, go into effect controls, and keyframe both scale and position for the first frame. We'll go for a light zoom with scale at 130. After that, we'll use the parameters of position to make it so that our subject is just about center frame. Then we'll scrub the timeline onward to the last frame and hit the reset parameter buttons on both position and scale, putting them back to their default values. Now go into the effects panel, type lens, and drag the lens distortion effect onto your nested layer on the timeline. In effect controls under lens distortion, put the curvature at -5 to add to the surrealism. We have just created a subtle zoom out effect and some distortion to go with the rest of the dreamy atmosphere. Keep in mind though, for heavy zoom effects, it is always wise to use footage of a higher resolution than your current sequence, so you are left with some headroom to prevent dips in quality. So if your sequence is at 1080p, consider using footage of 1440p or higher. Anyway, these are the results of our work. A vibe that is both atmospheric and surreal at the same time. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. Like and subscribe for more, and as always, catch you all on the next one.